Hello friends, in this video, I am going to discuss the concept of velocity analysis by relative velocity method. Here, with the help of relative velocity method, we can define the velocity of any particular point with respect to another point. So let's start the concepts of relative velocity method by which we can define the velocity of any particular point which has direction, and that velocity we can define with respect to any other point which has magnitude and direction both. So let's start the relative velocity method and the velocity analysis of different points. So here, as I told you about the relative velocity method, we generally use the concept of relative velocity. So the velocity of any particular point with respect to another point, by this concept we can define the relative velocity. So here, if we are considering two different points and both the point have two different velocity, so one point will move with respect to another point. So relative velocity method basically depend on one condition. If we are considering two points and at one point we have to define the magnitude of velocity with respect to another point, so that another point should have magnitude and direction of velocity both. So as per the statement, if we want to define the magnitude of velocity of any particular point which has the direction only, so we can use another point which has magnitude and direction of velocity both. So here I am going to discuss this particular statement with the help of one diagram, and this statement is representing the relative velocity method. We are going to define the velocity of any particular point with respect to another point, that is called the relative velocity, and this condition should satisfy to define the velocity of any particular point with respect to another point. So here we are considering one link. This arbitrary shape is representing the link. And on this particular link, I am taking two points A and B. And here, this point A is in the motion as well as this point B is in the motion. And this point A is moving with velocity VA and this point B is moving with velocity VB. Now, let us consider the point A which has the velocity VA. So, this VA has magnitude and direction both. And at point B, we have only the direction. We don't have the magnitude. So, how we can define the magnitude of this particular velocity VB? So, here we will use the concept of relative velocity method. So, for that, we will draw a velocity diagram. So on this particular link, as I told you, we are taking two points A and B. So A is moving with velocity VA, B is moving with velocity VB, and A is having magnitude and direction. This VA is represented by the magnitude and direction both, and this VB is represented by the direction only. So here we have to define the magnitude of VB. So first of all, we will draw a velocity diagram for this particular motion of the link where two points are in motion. So this diagram is representing the velocity diagram or the vector diagram for the motion of A and B. Now here, how we can draw the velocity diagram? So to analyze this velocity VB with the help of velocity diagram is generally representing the relative velocity method. In relative velocity method, we generally use this velocity diagram to define the velocity of any particular point. So here, first of all, we will mark a reference point. Anywhere we can mark this reference point as per our convenience. Now here I have marked this point O here. Now we have the magnitude of velocity VA. So here our first step is to mark the reference point. So this is our first step. Now, second step, here we have VA in direction as well as in magnitude. So from point O, we will draw a line which is representing the magnitude of VA as well as in the same direction, and this particular VA will mark by OA. So here we will start from point O and we will end this VA at point A, that is equal to magnitude of VA. So this is our second step. So here we have this particular VA. Now here, as we know, if we want to define the velocity of point B with respect to point A, so as per the concept of motion of link, we can define this relative velocity by VBA, and this VBA will act perpendicular to AB. So here we have this VBA perpendicular to VB, and this VB is representing the direction of point B. So here we have to define this magnitude of VB, and we have the direction. So on the basis of direction, we can draw VB, but we don't have magnitude, so we cannot have the endpoint. So here what we will do, here we have the direction of VBA perpendicular to AB. So from point A, we will draw a line parallel to VBA. This particular line we will draw parallel to VBA in the same direction. So this is representing relative velocity of B with respect to point A. Now here, so this is our third point. From point A, draw a line perpendicular to AB, and it will represent the velocity of point B with respect to A. So here from point A, here we have the line perpendicular to AB, that is representing VBA. So it will be parallel to VBA. Now here we have this reference point O and we have this point B. So this BA is representing VBA. So from point O, next point is we will draw a line and it will intersect this AB at a particular point. So this particular line will represent the value of VB or magnitude of VB. As we have the direction, so as per this direction, we can draw this line OB, and it will intersect, this particular line is intersecting at point B. So this OB is representing VB. So if we want to define the magnitude of VB, so we can have this particular line or dimension of this particular line OB. So with the help of this dimension, we can define the magnitude of VB. So here if we have the dimension of OB, so it will represent the magnitude of VB. Now here let's see this diagram again, where we have already defined the value of VB with the help of dimension of OB. We will measure this OB and we can define the magnitude of VB. Now here if we are considering any point on link AB, so let's see this diagram. Here on this AB, if we are taking this point C, so this point C is dividing AB in AC and BC. So here we have one ratio of division AC and BC. Now if we consider this particular point C on velocity diagram, and if we define the position of C in velocity diagram, so this point C is dividing this line VBA with same ratio as this point C is dividing this line AB. So on that particular concept, we can define the position of point C on this velocity diagram. So by this way, we can define the position of point C on velocity diagram. So how we can define the position of point C on this diagram, I'm going to define. So as we know, on the diagram of link, we have the position of point C. So here we will mark This particular AB is representing VBA. So, on this particular VBA, we will mark the position of point C. As the same ratio we are having, the point C is on the link AB. Here we have point C and this is dividing into AC and AB. So, whatever ratio we have AC and BC, same ratio we will consider here on AB as AC and BC. So, we will mark the position of point C here, and to define the velocity of point C with respect to point A, we can mark this particular reference point and we will draw a line up to point C. Here we will join point O and point C. So, this particular line will represent the velocity VC. And with the help of this particular VA and VC, we can define the velocity VCA. So, AC will represent velocity of point C with respect to point A, that is VCA. And the same concept we can apply on any other point, like if we are considering any point E somewhere here. So, if it is dividing AB as AE and BE, so we will mark this point E here on this velocity diagram. With the same ratio, this point E is dividing the link, and here we will again join this point O with point E. So, this OE will represent VE and this AE will represent VEA, that is equals to AE. So, any point we can mark somewhere in between the link, and that point we can draw here on the velocity diagram with the same ratio. Now, this is the point we are considering on a link only, but if we are considering any point outside the link, so here let us see one point D which we are considering outside the link. So, this particular D we will join with the extreme point A and B. So, here if we are taking this point D as outside point, so we will join A and D, and this ABD we will consider as a triangle. So, here we will use this ratio of the triangle ADB in this velocity diagram. So, we will mark this point D with the help of triangle. So, this AD will represent capital AD and this BD will represent capital BD. And we will form a triangle with the same ratio here. And here we have the point D with the help of this AD and BD. So, this particular triangle small ABD is representing the triangle capital ABD, and we will mark the point D, and from point O we will join this point D. So, this particular line will represent the velocity of point D. Dimension of this OD will represent VD, dimension of this OC will represent VC. And with the help of this VD, we can define the relative velocity of point D with respect to point A, that is represented by VDA. So, these are the different conditions by which we can define the velocity of different point on a link. Either it is on the link or it is away from the link or outside the link. So, here we will mark point C and point D, and accordingly we can define the velocity of point C and point D. So, this is about the velocity of different point. Now, these points are related to linear velocities only. Here in this diagram, we are considering linear velocity. For point B, it is moving with velocity VB, and the relative velocity of point B with respect to point A, it is represented by VBA. Similarly, point C and point D is also represented by the linear velocities. Now, if we are considering this particular link is moving with some angular velocity omega. So, here omega we are considering as the angular velocity for link AB, where point B is moving with respect to point A. So, we will define this VBA in terms of rotational velocity or angular velocity. So this VBA we can define by omega into AB, or this omega we can define as omega AB. So it will be So omega we can define by VBA by AB. AB is the perpendicular distance and that is equals to AB by AB. So this is about the rotational motion of any particular point with respect to another point. So we can define this angular velocity for any particular point. So this is all about the relative velocity. Here one point you have to remember about this point C. This point C we have to mark with same ratio on this AB, as this point C is dividing this AB. The ratio will be same, and with same ratio we can mark this point C. So this ratio we can define as AC by AB, that is equals to capital AC by capital AB. So this small term is representing the velocity diagram and this capital term is representing the actual diagram of the link. So this is all about the relative velocity method. Thank you so much.